Finally, to Union Territories. Union Territories are regions with different culture and social practices which make it difficult for them to merge with the present state, and they are not big enough to form a separate state. And our country has 7 Union Territories, and we will see them in detail. Andaman and Nicobar Islands, one of the 7 Union Territories of India, are a group of islands at the junction of Bay of Bengal and Andaman Sea. It includes 2 island groups, the Andaman Islands and Nicobar Islands. Andaman Islands are home to the Sentinelese people, an uncontacted people group. They are indigenous people of northern Sentinel Island in Andaman Islands of India. They resist contact with the outside world. They are among the last people group to remain virtually untouched by modern civilization. They are hunter-gathering societies subsisting through hunting, fishing, and collecting wild plants. They don't practice agriculture. I am not sure about this, but I think now there are some people contacts, even though government is not encouraging it. During European colonization, the island was under Danish rule. In 1868, Denmark sold its rights to Britain, which made them part of British India. Britain established their colony at Port Blair. The primary purpose was to set up a penal colony for criminals convicted from Indian subcontinent. The colony came to include infamous cellar jail, more popularly known as Kala Pani, which means black waters. Lot of our freedom fighters were imprisoned here. For a short term, during World War II, the island was under Japanese control. Later, this island were reoccupied by British. After independence of both India and Burma, the departing British announced their intention to resettle all Anglo-Indians and Anglo-Burmese on this island to form their own nation. But it never happened, and it became a part of India in 1950 and a Union Territory in 1956. There are 572 islands in Andaman and Nicobar. The uninhabited islands of Andaman Archipelago is called Sister Islands. The only active volcano in India is in Barren Island. It erupted on 2017. Commercial fishing is banned in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are strategically important for India due to its greater proximity to Southeast Asian countries like Indonesia, Thailand, Malaysia, and Malacca Strait. Largest sea turtle, the leatherback sea turtle, nests on these islands. You can find a lot of large coconut crabs in these islands. You can also find a lot of butterflies migrating here. Therefore, this island is also known as the Happy Land of Butterflies. The southernmost tip of India is known as Indira Point. These islands are under the jurisdiction of Calcutta High Court. Chandigarh. Chandigarh is a city and union territory in India that serves as the capital of 2 neighboring states of Haryana and Punjab. It is unique because it is not a part of either of the 2 states, but is governed directly by the union government. Chandigarh means fortress of goddess Chandi, a Hindu god. It was the first planned city in India after independence. The master plan of the city was prepared by the Swiss-French architect Le Corbusier. Most of the government buildings and housing in the city were designed by Chandigarh Capital Project team headed by Le Corbusier. Chandigarh is one of the perfect city of the world in terms of architecture and modernization. Chandigarh Capital Complex was declared by UNESCO as World Heritage Site in 2016. It comprises 3 buildings, 3 monuments and a lake including Palace of Assembly, Secretariat, High Court, Open Hand Monument, Geometric Hill and Tower of Shadows. It is one of the cleanest cities in India with high per capita income and human development index. The metropolitan areas of Chandigarh, Mohali and Panchkula collectively called as tri-cities. 8,000 years ago, the area was also known to be home to Harappan civilization. Chandigarh was the dream city of India's first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. After partition, British province of Punjab split into East and West Punjab. Lahore was the old capital and Lahore was in Pakistan-Punjab side. So there was a necessity for a new capital. Government carved out Chandigarh of nearly 50 Pawadi-speaking villages of East Punjab. Shimla was the temporary capital until Chandigarh was completed in 1960. If you see the map of Chandigarh, you can see it is divided into numbered sectors closed by roads for easy transport. But there is no sector 13, you know, superstitious belief of bad luck. There are no statues in Chandigarh. It was the condition of the architect. Official emblem of Chandigarh is open hand, which signifies peace and reconciliation. The open hand sent a message of open to give and receive. The city is base for three governments. So most of the people residing there are either government officers or retired ones. This has given the city the title the Pensioner's Paradise. Network of roads in Chandigarh is called 7 V's, with vertical roads called paths and horizontal roads called marges. Central Plaza in Sector 17 is called Pedestrian's Paradise, intended to avoid any traffic, and it is a hot destination of people during weekends. Chandigarh city is a part of Chandigarh capital region, which also include Panchkula, Mohali, Karar, Kurali, and Sirakpur. BBC survey in 2016 tagged Chandigarh as the perfect city in the world. Lee Corbusier conceptualized Chandigarh as analog to human body, the head being Capitol complex in Sector 1, lungs being the open space and greenery, circulatory system being the 7 V's, and brain be in the educational institutions. The best time to visit Chandigarh is in autumn. It seems like an European city because of its architecture, cycle tracks, fountains and roads. Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Dadra and Nagar Haveli is a union territory in western India. It is composed of two separate geographical entities. Nagar Haveli wedges between Maharashtra and Gujarat, and 1 kilometer to the northwest, the small enclave of Dadra, which is surrounded by Gujarat. Nagar Haveli was ruled by Marathas till 1779. These 72 villages were offered to Portuguese following a friendship treaty. Later, Portuguese purchased Dadra. Under Portuguese rule, Dadra and Nagar Haveli were a part of Daman district of Portuguese state of India. First, Dadra was its capital, later they shifted to Silvassa. Portuguese rule in India lasted until 1954, even after 1947 independence from British. Later, it was captured by the supporters of Union of India. Even after the creation of Republic of India, Portugal held a handful of territories on Indian subcontinent like the district of Goa, Daman and Diu, and Dadra and Nagar Haveli. They are collectively known as Estate of the India. In 1961, when Indian forces took over Goa and Daman and Diu, K.G. Badalani, an IAS officer, was for one day designated as the Prime Minister of Dadra and Nagar Haveli, so that as the head of the state, he could sign an agreement with the then Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, for formally merging Dadra and Nagar Haveli with the Republic of India. Deliberation and annexion of Dadra and Nagar Haveli was quite interesting. None of India's armed force was involved in this action. It was done by a group of civilians and some nationalist organizations like United Front of Goans. Finally, Dadra and Nagar Haveli is under the jurisdiction of Mumbai High Court. Daman and Diu. Daman and Diu is a union territory in western India with an area of 112 km². It is the smallest federal division of India on the mainland. The territory comprises of two distinct regions, Daman and Diu, geographically separated by Gulf of Cambodia. The state of Gujarat and Arabian Sea borders the territory. Daman is surrounded by Valsad district of Gujarat, while Diu is surrounded by Gir Somnath district. Since 15th, it was a Portuguese colony. The territories were amalgamated in India in 1961 through a military conquest. Portuguese did not recognize the Indian annexion of these territories until the Carnation Revolution of 1974. Until 1987, the territory of Goa and Daman and Diu was administered as a single union territory. Later, Goa was granted statehood, leaving Daman and Diu as a separate union territory. There is no post of Lieutenant Governor or Chief Minister like in Delhi or Pondicherry here. Both Daman and Diu and Dadra and Nagar Haveli are ruled by administrators. Both are administrated by the same administrator. Culture of Daman and Diu is a blend of traditional Gujarati and Maharashtrian culture with some traces of Portuguese custom. Economy of Daman and Diu is derived by fishing and salt farming. Daman is divided by Daman Ganga into two parts, Nani Daman or Small Daman and Moti Daman or Big Daman. Interestingly, Small Daman is the largest and busiest out of both. It is a commercial center, most of the hotels, restaurants and markets are found here. Moti Daman is a heritage town of Daman. Indian Coastal Guard Air Station in Daman is the premier air station of Coastal Guard with all airfield facilities. Like Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu is also under the jurisdiction of Mumbai High Court. Gudwada is not in Daman but just 15 kilometers from town. It is known for the traditional Parsi cuisine. Delhi. Delhi, officially the National Capital Territory of Delhi, is a city and a union territory of India. Not to be confused, actually, New Delhi, the capital of India, is located entirely within the city of Delhi. It is bordered by Haryana on three sides and Uttar Pradesh to the east. It is the only union territory with a high court of its own, also a secretariat and a legislative assembly. Delhi's urban area is now considered to extend beyond the National Capital Territory boundaries and include neighboring cities of Faridabad, Gurgaon, Noida, and Ghaziabad in an area now called Central National Capital Region, and it is the world's second largest urban area after Tokyo. It is also the second wealthiest city in India after Mumbai. Delhi has been continuously inhabited since 16th century BC. Throughout history, Delhi has served as the capital of various kingdoms, and it has been captured, ransacked, and rebuilt several times. Delhi was ruled by Delhi Sultanate, Mughals, Sikhs, and British East India Company got Delhi during Second Anglo-Maratha War, in which Maratha forces were defeated in the Battle of Delhi. In 1911, British shifted their capital of British India from Calcutta to Delhi. Modern Delhi is a cluster of number of cities spread across the metropolitan region. Delhi is not an absolute union territory or a state. Even though it is a union territory, Delhi more closely resembles that of a state of India because it has its own legislature, high court, and an executive council of ministers headed by a chief minister. Delhi and Pondicherry has separate chief ministers and legislative assembly. New Delhi is the capital of National Capital Territory of Delhi, and it is jointly administered by the Federal Government of India and the local government of Delhi. The first Asian Games in 1951 was hosted in Delhi. Tihar Jail is the largest prison complex in India. Indira Gandhi International Airport is the busiest airport in India. Delhi Jama Masjid is the largest mosque in India. Khari Bayoli Market is Asia's largest wholesale spice market. Qutub Minar is world's tallest brick minaret. New Delhi is the world's second most bird-rich capital city after Kenya's Nairobi. Delhi faces a serious problem of air pollution. Currently, government is trying different methods to control it. Lotus Temple in Delhi is the house of worship of Baha'i religion. India has the highest population of Baha'i faith, but most of Indians doesn't know much about this religion. It's a 19th century young religion. They also believe in one God, also accept all other religions. They believe in unity and equality. It's a very young religion with a very good concept. Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep is a group of islands in the southwestern coast of India. The archipelago is a union territory and is governed by central government of India. Lakshadweep is an archipelago of 12 atolls, 3 reefs and 5 submerged banks. Formerly, the union territory of Lakshadweep was known as Lakshadweep, Minicoy and Amindiv Islands. Later, they changed its name to Lakshadweep by an act of parliament in 1973. The name Lakshadweep came from Sanskrit word Lakshadweepa, which means 100,000 islands. It is the smallest union territory of India. The region forms a single Indian district with 10 subdivisions. Kavarthi is its capital and the region comes under the jurisdiction of Kerala High Court. During the medieval period, the region was ruled by Chola dynasty of Kingdom of Kananur. Later, Portuguese arrived but they left soon. Then the region was ruled by Muslim House of Arakkal, the only Muslim kingdom of Kerala. During British Raj, these islands were attached to Malabar district of Madras Presidency. On 1st November 1956, during the recognition of Indian states, the Lakshadweep Islands were separated from Madras and organized into a separate union territory for administrative purposes. Out of 36 islands, only 10 islands are inhabited. The islanders are ethnically similar to Malayali people of the nearest state of Kerala. Most of the people speak Malayalam, but their pronunciation is little different but understandable. Actually, in Kerala itself, the pronunciation of Malayalam in each district is different. For example, Malayalam word for what is enda. People of 14 districts in Kerala pronounce it in 14 different ways, like endira, endua, ende, ennada, endutta, enna, like that. But in Minicoy Island, Mahi of Maldives is spoken here. There is an airport in Agathi Island. Main occupation of people is fishing and coconut cultivation. I also heard that there is no movie theaters on Lakshadweep, but I couldn't find anything about that on internet. Indian Navy base INS Deeprakshika is commissioned on Kavarthi Island. Unlike other Indian states, instead of wife, here husband goes to his wife's place, but husband takes surname of wife. Intercaste marriages are not permissible and polygamy is practiced here except on Minicoy Island. One cannot own or buy land or plot on Lakshadweep unless he or she is born there. Pondicherry. Pondicherry is mentioned in Roald Dahl's famous book, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. A prince named Pondicherry ordered Willy Wonk to make a chocolate castle in Pondicherry. So he does, but the chocolate castle melts away in summer heat. Puducherry literally means new town in Tamil. Formerly known as Pondicherry, the territory officially changed its name to Puducherry on 2006. It was formed out of four enclaves of former French India, namely Puducherry, Karikkal, Mahi and Yanam. The entire union territory is named after its largest district, Puducherry. The areas of Puducherry district and Karikkal district are bound by the state of Tamil Nadu, while Yanam district and Mahi district are closed by the states of Andhra Pradesh and Kerala respectively. In 1674, Puducherry became a French colony of French colonial empire together with Chandar Nagar, Mahi, Yanam, Karikkal and Musilipattanam. It formed a French colony of French India under a single French governor in Puducherry. The territory of French India were completely transferred to the Republic of India de facto on 1st November 1954 and de jure on 16th August 1962. When French India ceased to exist, these four coastal enclaves became a union territory of India. Mahi is smallest among these four. This city lies on the bank of Mahi River. Pondicherry also has its own legislature and elected chief minister as Delhi. Madras High Court have jurisdiction here. The plan of city of Pondicherry is based on the French grid pattern and features perpendicular streets. The town is divided into two sections, French quarters and Indian quarters. In French quarters, the buildings are typically in French colonial style with long compounds and stately walls. While Indian quarters consist of houses lined with verandas and with large doors and grills. French language can be seen on road signs and menus in restaurants. Also, French influence can be seen in culture, architecture and in food. Please watch all my 30 videos about the states and union territories, and I think these videos help you to understand our country a little more better. And thanks for watching.